Hello friends, welcomes you to Fisheries Only, Nourishing Fish, Nurturing Life, our educational YouTube channel. Today we will see the RAS best for aquaculture, that is recirculatory aquaculture system, that is RAS. In this video we are going to discuss what is the RAS technology and how to avail the subsidy for this technology. Recirculatory aquaculture system, that is short form is RAS, is a high density culture where water is recirculated and reused after mechanical and biological filtration and removal of suspended matter and metabolites, that is called as a recirculatory aquaculture system, where is a scarcity of land as well as water is available. Less water is available. In this situation, we can go for the recirculatory aquaculture system. This is the best system. In a confined area, we can predict more production, more quality fish instead of going for the larger ponds with available of large use of the water resources. RAS is nothing but the aquaculture system where water is recycled and reused after mechanical and biological filtration for removing of suspended and dissolved nutrients from the water, and this water again reused. In this system, this is a high density aquaculture system where minimum land area required as well as a minimum quantity of water also required. In a minimum or a scarcity of water, we can go for this system. Fish are cultured in indoor as well as the outdoor tanks. Mechanical or biological filters we need to use here. That is the main purpose to improve the quality of the water which is used in the fish tank. After that, this is the RAS. Here only water is added to compensate the evaporation rate and any splash of the water. In this system, not more than 10% not more than 10% of total volume of water is added per day respectively. That is addition also limited to the 10% only, and we are only reusing and recycling the. In this, it is a intensive high density fish culture unlike other aquaculture production system. Instead of traditional method of growing fish in outdoor ponds and raceways, in these systems are typically reared indoor and outdoor units. Recirculatory systems use a filter for cleaning the water and by removing the suspended as well as the dissolved nutrients material from the water. The technology is based on mechanical as well as biological filtration, and method can be used for growing the species in aquaculture. New water is added up to 10% only to make out the compensate, to make or compensate the evaporation loss or any splash loss during the operations. In order to complete economical and efficiently use of the suspended capital investment recirculatory system, the fish farmer needs to grow much fish possible, that is higher stock intensity are done in this unit. Numerous filter designs, any ozonation unit, ultraviolet units or oxygenation unit we can do for removing of the water. Some biological filter, that is nitrifying bacteria, we can use to convert the ammonia into nitrate and nitride. So this is can be operated in a backyard, small ground or hatchery This can be operated in a backyard of the house in small area where scarcity of land and water is there. Then we can go for this high density, high production, high quality of fish production system is a RAS system. It encourages the small fish farmers to build up the enterprise and to facilitate the production in urban as well as semi-urban areas where land and water resources are scarce. It is proposed to promote the backyard recirculatory aquaculture system. This is the nothing but the RAS aquaculture system. Now we will see the species suitable for RAS. That is first one is Barramundi. That is Asian sea bass. That is Latus calcarifer is also suitable and prone. Very good species for the RAS culture system. Second one is Copia. Then silver or Indian pompano. Pompano. Then tilapia is a very famous fish. We can go for this RAS system. That is Oreochromis niloticus species or gift tilapia. We can culture in this RAS system. Then pulse for that is Atropellus suratensis species. We can use Pangasius species. We can use rainbow trout. That is Oncorhynchus micis. That is in cold water bodies we can go for these rainbow trout culture, that is rainbow trout culture in a RAS in cold water aquaculture systems. These are the suitable species we can go for with the RAS circulatory systems. Now we will see how the RAS is working. In RAS is already we have discussed, that is a fish drying tank is there. After that the tank, the water is removed from the tank through the mechanical filter. First the screening and sanitation was carried out. Solid particles mostly are removed by the mechanical filter. Then it goes for it transported or moved for or pumped for the biological filter where ammonia removal is a main work done. Ammonia removal by the beneficial nitrifying bacteria are used here. So many biological filters are available and that filters we can use here. After the biological filtration, we can go for sterilization of water, that is UV sterilization or ozonization. We can go for that. And after that, the aeration we can do. We can add oxygen and we can remove the carbon dioxide from the water and then only we can re-enter in the fish rearing tank this water. Thus the waters are recirculated, mechanical filter, biological filter, then UV sterilization, aeration was done and after that the water is reused in the aquaculture or RAS system. Now we will just see the components of the RAS system. First one is we require insulated shed or buildings to establish this unit. Then store cum office for preserve the laboratory equipment, feeds and other operating space. We require store cum office. Then pump house is most important to supply or to pump the water from one unit, that is a culture unit, to the mechanical filter, to the biological filter, after sterilization, after that aeration system, that is pump house is required and various pumps capacity with different capacity pumps are required here. Then we require grow out tanks may be in a plastic circular pools or any we can go for a cement and other fiberglass tanks we can use in that. Maybe in square or rectangular tanks we can use for that purpose. Then settling tanks, water storage sumps, these are the nothing but the mechanical filtrations. Overhead tanks we have required. Then drum, glass wool, muslin cloths, all others are equipments are required. Pumps and motors are also required. Power generator is a essential part. In failure of electricity, we need a power generator or any backup system to operate the system, as there is a continuous process to recirculate the aquaculture water in the system. We require continuous power supply, so as there may be a backup or power generator is needed. Sludge collector, settleable solid collector is also one part. Biofilters and UV sterilization or ozone sterilization. Electrifications are important. Automatic feeders we can use in this system to feed the fish. And most important, aeration systems also required to aerate the water to maintain the oxygen level in the water system. And water supply system also required, which include the overhead tank and any borewell water or any river water or other any source of water, that is well water with minimum hardness we can use for this purpose. That is, water supply system is needed with a good source of water is need to available to feed, to pump the water in the rearing units. These are the simple components of the RAS system, and these are the working principle of the RAS system. Now just we will move towards the advantages of the RAS system. What are the advantages of these recirculatory aquaculture system? It is a system that is having extended durability, as the tanks and all material we are using here are good quality, and concrete or many fiberglass tanks, that's the durability of this unit is higher. Reduced dependency on antibiotics and therapeutics, that's why we can produce the good quality fish food in this system. As already discussed, all systems, all species, mostly suitable species, that is barramundi, that is essential bass, gift tilapia, rainbow trout, pulse pot, that we can culture in this. Reduction of direct operational cost. Here we can go for feed management, that is demand feeders also we can use, and hence the operational cost also control in this system. Control on predator and parasites is easy here, as all the waters are we are going to circulate and filter through the biological as well as mechanical filter. That's why there is a less chance of predator and parasites getting affected to the fishes. Risk reduction due to climatic factors. Here some factors we can control, climatic factors we can control here. It is an indoor or outdoor unit. In that unit we can maintain our oxygen level on all hazardous particles. We can remove ammonia level, we can remove with the help of this biological filtration and mechanical filtration. So due to the control on the climatic factor, there is a less risk on production of these fishes. That means there is a less chance of getting fish affected with the diseases. Environmental parameter monitoring systems also important. We can monitor environmental parameters, so the risk on production is less. Production of diversified species irrespective of temperature requirements we can do here. This we can go for depending upon in cold water, we can go for cold water RAS culture. In warm water bodies, we can go for warm water fishes, which is suitable for the RAS system. We can go for diversified or wide range of the varieties we can culture in this system, and these enable RAS system enable secure production of non-endemic species. We can predict our production within a period of culture period. This is most judicial use of water and land areas for fish production. This system prefer judicial or promote the judicial use of the water as well as land area for the fish production. That's the advantages of the systems are of the RAS system. But with the advantages, there are some disadvantages also is there. Just we will see what are the disadvantages. Here we can continuously pumping the water and filtering the water through the mechanical and biological filters. So continuous uninterrupted power supply is required. So we need to a power backup for this system. If electricity power fails, then backup of electricity is a must in this system. Capital cost of the starting of these aquacultures, RAS aquaculture, is higher than other pond system because here we can going for high density culture, high controls on our culture. So mechanical and biological filters and tanks and recirculatory mechanism we are using here. That's why the capital cost for this is higher, but this is durable for the most of the period of times. Now we will see the how feed we can manage in this recirculatory aquaculture system. High quality feed, high protein feed we can go for with essential minerals and vitamins. Feed we can choose for this system as it is fully depend on the artificial feeding. So good quality feed we have to first select, then specific species feed we have to select. Mostly for carnivorous species we have to go for the higher protein feeds, that is species specific feed we can choose depending upon their growth. The size of the feed also we can go for that. Then feeding we can done at the rate of the 3 to 5% of the body weight of the fish, and the ration we can give at a several time, so the fish will consume will waste the less feed, and the FCR of the total aquaculture system, that RAS system, will be improved. That is more frequent feeding, that is several times, 4 to 5 times we can go for that, mostly 3 times also we can go for that. So give a better FCR, that is food conversion ratio, that is they feeds less feed and grow more without wasting the feeds. That is improved feed conversion ratio we can achieve in this RAS aquaculture system by proper monitoring the feeding and quality of the feed. Also by using the demand feeder, that is automatic demand feeders also we can use in this system. Just now we will just see the one unit for GIF tilapia, that is genetically improved tilapia, farm tilapia. For making one unit, mostly the capital required for the six life to develop one unit of the GIF tilapia culture in RAS system, to develop required capital is near about 6 lakh rupees, and working capital required is near about 1.5 to 2 lakh rupees. These 6 plus 2, that is minimum to operate the one cycle. Firstly, working capital required 1.5 to 2 lakh, and capital cost, that is cost on the equipments and our masonry parts and tanks, it will be goes up to the 6 lakh rupees. For GIF tilapia, we can see the one unit, that is one tank of the 6.7 meter into 6.7 meter into 2 meter, that size of the tank we can go for. This volume of the tank is 90 meter cube. Then stocking size, we can stock fingerlings in this at the rate of 6000 fingerlings per one tank. We can expect 90% of the survival, 85 to 90% we can expect the survival. We can expect FCR, that is food conversion ratio, is 1:1.3. Culture period may be of 6 months for a gift tilapia to become a fingerling to harvestable size. It requires 6 months. Then cost of CV is near about 4 rupees per rupees 30 kg per kg, and total feed required is near about 3.5 tons. Size at the harvesting may be, the fish will be reached near about the 500 grams, and expected biomass is near about 2.7 ton, that is 2700 kg production we can expect with the help of 90% survival of the seed. And sell price we can get after 140 kg per fish, we can expect after selling gross income near about 3,78,000. These are the mostly economics for the culture of one unit in one culture period. Thus, we can go for two cultures or mostly 1.5 culture in this per yearly, and we can go for adding units and improving the production. Once the capital is made, capital cost is happen, then only we have to only go for the or working capitals only. There is we need only maintenance and repairing of on capital, that is expenditure on capital structure such as the tank and filters only, and only we have to go for the working capital. Here we can get subsidies under the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana, that is PMMSY, and to avail this subsidy we have to go for the project report through the concerned district fisheries officer for further process. We have to complete the technical report as well as a guideline report, any land area, unit wise. We have to detail project report, we have to prepare, and we have to submit to the district fisheries officer for the further process. Governmental assistance will be restricted to one large, one medium, and one small unit for individual beneficiary. That assistance we can get from the subsidy, we can get from the through the PMMSY Yojana. For training details, we can go for the trainer, that is a Dr. I.S. Bright Singh, which is a professor from the National Center for Aquatic Animal Health, Cochin, University of Science and Technology, University Road, South Kerala. From here we can get your training on the RAS system. So these are the system which is beneficial to improve the fish production with the help of in the scarcity of the land and water area, to enhance the India's fish production, to improve the quality of the cultured animals, and to predict the quantity also. We number of quantity or production we can predict, and we can go for the backward calculation, and units we can develop, and we can go for the decided production within a period. Thus friends, we learn about the RAS system, that is a recirculatory aquaculture system, which can be beneficial in a scale of the land and water area to enhance the our fish production with good quality fish production. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and promote the channel. Thank you.